Hello, my friends. If you're unaware, there's been some pretty big news coming from Createx over the last several days. If you're new to the channel, I use Createx products pretty much exclusively for everything that I do. Colorcraft has a number of different paint brands that fall under the Createx Colors logo. The ones that I use more often than anything else have been traditionally the Auto Air Colors line, the Wicked Colors line, the Wicked Detail Colors line, and the Illustration Colors line. Createx has changed things up. If we go to the internet and type in autoaircolors.com, you see it has been discontinued. So, Auto Air Colors has been discontinued? Yes and no. Here's the deal. Createx first brought Auto Air Colors to market back in 2002, and to my knowledge, it was the very first water-based paint that was designed specifically for custom automotive applications. That doesn't mean that was the only thing you could use it on. It was actually really good on a very wide variety of surfaces. But the first formulations were brought to market back in 2002. In fact, I still have a few of those very first formulations in stock right here. You can tell by the labels on the bottle. That 19-year-old paint still works just fine. The technology was in its infancy at the time, so those original formulations don't spray nearly as well as the Createx products that we have available to us today. One of the main reasons why I have remained a loyal Createx user is due to the fact that they are constantly upgrading all of their products as well as introducing new products to market. So fast forward to 2008 when Wicked Colors was introduced. The biggest difference at the time was Createx developed a new resin for the Wicked Colors line that was actually outperforming the resin they were using in the Auto Air Colors line, which goes back to what I mentioned just a minute ago about Createx constantly working on improving their existing products as well as developing brand new products. Naturally, they started using the newer resin in the Auto Air Colors as well. At the end of the day, what they had was two different brands that were essentially the same product. So what they've decided to do is merge the two together. Auto Air Colors no longer exists as a brand. It has been merged with Wicked Colors. So you can go to the website and you can still find almost all of the colors that were available in the Auto Air Colors line. They are just now under the Wicked Colors line. So we still have the full line of the transparent colors. You have all of the fluorescent colors. You have the pearl and metallic colors, which includes quicksilver, gold chrome, and the iridescent colors. You have the pearl flakes, which includes the highlight, the hot rod sparkle, the cosmic sparkle, and the flare tints. And of course, we still have the detail colors. I think this merger is a good decision simply because it will alleviate some confusion when it comes to choosing which product you actually want to use, especially if you're new to airbrushing. Now, Createx and many other channels have already announced this information. So why is this important for this particular channel? It has to do with the fact that I still have a lot of Auto Air Colors in stock. In fact, some of the Auto Air Colors that I still have been discontinued now for a long period of time prior to this merger happening. So I will still be using Auto Air Colors in my videos for a long period of time from this point forward. When I make tutorial videos, I try to make it a point to use colors that are still available now, whether that's in the Wicked Colors line or the Illustration Colors line. I will also try to make it a point to steer you guys in the right direction for the same color or an equivalent color, whether that's in the Wicked Colors line or the Illustration Colors line. But that's not all. There's some other exciting news. One thing that I've never really liked about the Createx water-based paint system is the fact that you have to treat all of the colors as a transparent because they are more or less transparent by nature. For an example, in my True Fire video, I was using Illustration Scarlet Red to begin this panel. And if you guys have watched the video, it takes a very long time to build up the opacity using the Createx paint system. It will cover at some point, but it takes a long time to get there. Some of you even left comments saying that was painful to watch, and I completely agree it was. You could find some semi-opaque colors under the Auto Air Colors badge, but even those were very transparent in nature based on my own experience. You will not find the semi-opaque colors in the Wicked Colors line. Those were not part of the merger. The game changer, in my opinion, was the opaque colors. Createx released some opaque colors under the Illustration Colors line a year or two ago, and those are phenomenal. They've done it again. The Wicked Colors line now includes some opaque colors, and they are not the same colors that are available under the Illustration Colors line. The new Wicked opaque colors are supposed to be more opaque than anything else Createx has come up with to date, so I'm pretty excited to try them out. Unfortunately, I don't have any here yet. I've placed an order, but they didn't make it in time for this video. What I can do is show you a comparison between some colors using one of the Illustration opaque colors. So what I've done here is I mixed up Illustration Yellow, Wicked Golden Yellow, Auto Air Colors Semi-Opaque Chrome Yellow, and Illustration Opaque Chrome Yellow. I mixed all of these the exact same using a 20% per volume reduction ratio. So that's 4 parts paint, 1 part 4011 reducer. If you've watched some of my other videos, you're probably aware that I normally like to mix my paint at about a 1-to-1 ratio, meaning 1 part paint, 1 part reducer. In this case, I didn't want to over reduce the paint because I want it to be as opaque as it possibly can, even though some of these are actually transparent colors. I used a popsicle stick to stir up the contents, and then I allowed those to sit for a little while before we're actually going to spray them. I picked yellow intentionally because it's a weak color to begin with. It's not a powerful color. Yellow has a really hard time covering a very dark background like the small panel I have on my easel right now. So what I'm going to do is make 3 passes with each color, and then we can compare the difference. I've got the Illustration Yellow loaded up in my brush, so we'll get started. That was more like 6 passes, and it really didn't make a difference. In all fairness, the Illustration Yellow is a transparent color, so I did not expect any great results on that one. So now we'll try the Wicked Golden Yellow. There's no question the Wicked outperformed the Illustration Yellow by a lot. So now we'll try the Auto Air semi-opaque chrome yellow. Again, that's not terrible for six passes with the semi-opaque auto air chrome yellow. So now let's try the illustration opaque chrome yellow and you'll really see the difference. That, my friends, is what I call a significant difference. The Wicked on its own, not bad. The semi-opaque auto air colors, again, not bad, no longer available. But the opaque illustration chrome yellow is on a whole nother level. I hope this illustrates why I am so excited that Createx is bringing more of these opaque colors to the Wicked Colors line. That performance right there is on par with a solvent-based automotive urethane. And that's pretty cool because it's going to make a lot of the things that we do with our airbrush and paint so much easier to pull off. True fire or realistic fire, just to name one, will be so much easier with these opaque colors. Kudos to Createx for continuing to push the envelope, continuing to evolve their products and make them better versus just coming up with a system, putting it on the shelf, and selling it for decades without changing anything. This is really exciting. I hope you guys have got something out of this. I'll leave links in the description below to our friends over at Spray Gunner, where you can order any of the Createx line of products. I'll also leave a link in the description to the airbrush that I was using in this video. It's an Iwata Eclipse HPCS. It's my workhorse. I use it for probably 95% of what I do. It's a great brush. I highly recommend it. I hope you guys got something out of this. If you did, remember to like, subscribe, and share. I'm Trevor with Wicked Art Studio, and I'll see you guys next time.